sleep apnea specifically is really common, especially in older adults. It's equally common in men and women. It's associated with a higher risk of dementia. And excitingly, I guess, CPAP use. So no one wants to wear a CPAP machine, but when people do wear them and they adhere to that, it delays decline. And I've seen this actually in clinic where someone's come in with untreated sleep apnea and their testing almost looks like Alzheimer's disease. And then they go away and they really try very hard to adhere to that CPAP use every night. And then they come back and they look like a healthy older adult. So I'm a little bit of an evangelist when it comes to sleep apnea and CPAP. The reason why we think that happens is because when someone has sleep apnea, there's a diagram here, the airway collapses intermittently when they're sleeping, and that prevents the right amount of oxygen getting to the brain. And the hippocampus, which is the brain's memory center, is really an oxygen-hungry organ. And if we don't give it enough oxygen, it just doesn't behave. It doesn't do the consolidation of memories, which is meant to be doing overnight. So people get more forgetful. And then another reason that poor sleep is a problem for the brain is because the brain's clearance mechanism, the lymphatic or glymphatic system, clears amyloid when we have effective sleep. So if you don't have good sleep, you're not getting that quality overnight clearance. And that also causes problems. So we look at sleep apnea and sleep problems in width, and we've been really surprised by the prevalence, which has been about 80% of the women in width so far have some level of sleep apnea, and about 40% of those are moderate to severe. So it's really common. Most of those women had no idea that they had it. In women, it tends to present with less of the loud snoring and the gasping that you might see in men. So it's kind of a quieter syndrome and it goes under the radar. So this is some work by our graduate student, Kitty Liu, who has looked at these strong relationships that we're seeing between sleep apnea and tau, where worse sleep apnea seems to predict more tau in the women in width. But we get even stronger relationships when we just look at their sleep complaints. So if we just have to fill out a 10-minute questionnaire, we see relationships with tau in the top right there, section A, where the more complaints you have, the more tau you have, and with memory. So the green lines that you see there are a test called the brief visuospatial memory test, and we see really strong relationships between that and sleep complaints